Yeah, I think he's responded in that quoting
हाँ
German chat. Okay.
सो आई शुड स्टार्ट.
Yeah, you can start.
ओके सो आई तुषार एंड गौरव. गौरव आई गॉट इंट्रोड्यूस्ड लास्ट टाइम. सो गौरव यू सेड यू आर वर्किंग इन टोयोटा आई थिंक इफ आई रिमेंबर करेक्ट राइट.
Yeah, I'm working to it.
या एंड यू हैव बीन एन SAP एंड यूजर. एंड एंड तुषार what about you? If you can write, since you are not able to speak over the microphone, are you already an SAP user, or what is your SAP understanding? So based on that only I can start. If you are hearing us, Tushar, you can type in. I'm fresher to SAP. Okay. So you don't have any previous SAP experience, and neither as an end user also, right? Okay, that means I'll have to go from the basic. Okay, fine. So without wasting further time, let me just get started. You guys can let me know when you are able to see the screen here. I have one presentation before I go to the system. I just wanted to show today only go through what all EHS is all about, EHS with a C. So you can see Gaurav?
Yeah, definitely I can see.
So I hope Tushar might also be able to see this. Not sure.
Yeah, he's
Okay.
typed why.
No, I think after Y he typed Y is what?
Yes,
not
I
sure.
guess.
Yeah, Y is this, I guess. Yeah, fine. So I'll go today. I just want to cover what all this EHS is all about, and probably from next session onwards we will go into the system, or we'll see what all we can do through training courses. And this is what I just wanted to cover today. So I'll just quickly go through the slides, and I think this session is recorded. If Venky, you are there, you can confirm if this is recorded, then I'll consider all the participant who is the future participant and talk.
Yeah, it's recorded. You can.
Okay. So EHS was the old term. Nowadays that broader concept is called as sustainability. So often terms are used in EHS language which is called as sustainability also for large organizations. So we'll see what is SAP approach to sustainability, and why EHS systems are required, IT systems are required for handling various business pains and issues in various companies. And broadly, EHS is under three categories: health and safety considerations, environmental considerations, and product safety and stewardship for companies who are producing the products. This is something, sustainability performance management, that we won't be talking much on it, but this is something through which nowadays sustainability reports are generated. And lastly, we'll see some solution architecture, how SAP fits in overall SAP suite of solutions, and how it is talking to other modules of SAP. And there's something called as regulatory content, which we'll see. So this is the broad agenda which we'll cover today. This is the if you know holistic picture. If you want to see for EHS, this is how various roles are involved, and this is these are the business processes which gets covered. So the reporting directly goes to the C-suite level, CEOs and CXOs. And at the second level, most of the line of business people are involved, like safety engineer, product steward, environmental manager. And these are broadly some of the main process areas which SAP system caters to. We'll see more in the subsequent slides. But for now, you can consider there are three broad categories: health and safety, product safety and stewardship, and mountain performance. SAP RIA is something which is very country specific and regulation specific, that is recycle administration, which we won't be covering in our training.
Okay, Rohit, I have a question here.
Yes.
Can you go to the previous slide? Yeah. Here you are speaking about health and safety, product safety and stewardship and environmental performance. But I just went through SAP just like a few days ago, but in that, the environmental performance related modules or the aspects that we see is just environmental compliance. So are we going to speak more about sustainability part where environmental performance and product safety stewardship is involved? For example, sustainability reporting or sustainable strategies?
No, so the course content which you might have got through Venki is not having everything because it's a very, very broad topic. So we are concentrating more on the EHS fundamentals, which are the solutions which form the base of EHS. Some of the solutions which are very in advanced stage or the new solution for which even there is a whole process of setting up the solution and server that we won't cover from a training perspective in this particular training, but I'll be explaining from a conceptual perspective. So we'll be covering as part of this training the solutions which are the baseline of EHS solution, the fundamentals of EHS, which is mostly in health and safety and product safety and stewardship. Under environmental performance, we have emissions management, and that is something a different league of solution. But this slide is for you to understand what all comes under the EHS world.
Okay.
Right? Okay.
Okay.
So the sustainability performance which you are talking, that was something sustainability reporting, like companies have financial reporting. In the same way, some big companies nowadays are coming with sustainability reporting, which takes data from all the underlying solutions, including EHS also, the basic solutions.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
Yeah. Why this is required nowadays, why you have a system for EHS? In previous days, companies were managing somehow, but nowadays you probably can't manage because you have so many stakeholders involved. Customers are increasingly becoming more aware of your EHS processes and concerns around EHS. The regulators are becoming more strict, and you are every month or every year new regulations are coming to picture, which demands more transparency of your products and processes. Consumers are looking at whether the company is sustainable or not, the products are sustainable or not, and investors are also looking, the companies which are investing you are looking whether your process is sustainable or not from all perspective. So that's why it becomes very important nowadays to have some IT solution for your whole EHS program. And regulations are spent day by day, not only in developed countries but also in developing countries. So without any IT system, you won't be able to track all the regulations, and you will end up paying either a penalty or some damage in your brand reputation. And that has happened recently with many companies who has built the brand in so many years, and because of some non-compliance, they have got bigger penalties and brand deterioration. So you need to consider those aspects, and you need to come up with a holistic EHS system, which can, so that you can be compliant at the same time, you can reduce your operational risk also in the company. EHS is not that, it's only limited to the manufacturing and production processes. It is applicable to the entire value chain, right from the research and development to after the product sale, the services which is happening. So this slide tip talks in very briefly about under which step how EHS things are coming into play and how system can help you. So as the name suggests, and there are some quite obvious things here, you'll be able to relate once you go through this slide that how HS things come into play. So if somebody is having already HS background, he will be able to relate better how HS concern and things should be managed in an IT environment. So three pillars we talked about, and we'll go into detail now around the three pillars, and we'll try to see what exactly those consist of and what is there in the SAP systems. So when we talk about health and safety, it is talking about maintaining and ensuring that the person, employee or even contractor who are working for the company are in their healthy state and complying with local regulations around providing the health related data to the local authorities. Industrial hygiene talks about maintaining your workplaces such that there's very minimal risk or there's no risk to the people or processes who are working in those areas. Hazardous substance management is ensuring the same thing with the processes involved around hazardous substances, how you will store, how you will maintain the inventory, how you will have the up-to-date information for handling of those substances. And incident management is that you do anything, still some incidents happen, then if some incident happen in company, incident or accident, how reporting will happen and how investigation analysis will happen and the subsequent process will happen in the system. So these all together consist of the health and safety aspect of the solution. And like I was talking about industrial hygiene and safety, it is more about continuous improvement through monitoring and taking all the corrective actions just to ensure that the risks are mitigated and your workplaces are safe.
Just a minute, Ruth. I think Tushar has a problem with his audio.
Okay.
I think he's asking to dial through.
So can you hear Gaurav, my voice?
Yeah, I can hear clearly.
So there might be some bandwidth problem probably at Tushar. And Tushar, if you can hear now, you can type in. Please dial through phone. So you might be having some bandwidth problem. That's why it might be asking you to dial through phone. So if you are connected, Tushar, just let us know so that we can start again. I think somebody new arrived just now.
Tushar,
you're right. So Tushar, can you hear us now? Hello?
Yeah, Tushar, you muted our mic, just unmuted. Just unmute, press an unmute button on your keyboard. Rohit, you can proceed. I will call him and
Yeah, he looks like to be on mute only.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's on.
Hello.
Yes, Tushar.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Can you please proceed? Yeah, you can right now hear me, no? Right now I'm calling through my mobile, so I guess it's working fine.
Okay, so I'll continue.
Yeah, please.
Okay, so I was talking about some typical, these are business process flows, so I'll not be going much into detail because we'll see in system some of these processes. Only thing to explain that if somebody is coming from industry, then when I was talking about reducing the risk and all, how those things are actually done in the system and who all are the roles involved, in that. So you can see roles on the left hand side. These are the people who will be probably working on the SAP system to finally ensure that the risk is reduced. So it starts right from the identification of risk in the system, then doing the scientific process of risk assessment based on severity and probability, then determining the risk rating and the exposure groups, and finally taking the corrective action and reducing the risk and redoing the risk assessment. Those all things we'll be seeing in system later. Just this is just to give you an idea who are the persons involved in the whole process and how the actual flow happens in the system for a typical industrial hygiene and safety business process, right?
Rohit, I had one clarification here.
Yeah. First, Tushar, I just wanted to understand your background. Can you please briefly explain your background?
I have completed my postgraduation. Hello?
Yes.
I completed postgraduation in environmental science. Okay. And having 8 years of experience in renewable energy and greenhouse gas assessment.
Oh, great.
So I'm quite familiar with the environmental legislations and the compliance. And okay. As far as what are the terms that are now industrial hygiene, field personnel, product safety, MSDS, I'm having good exposure about this. I'm able to understand and the compliance and vision with the requirement needs to be followed for the product safety.
Okay, great. So you might have related yourselves to the initial slide which I was showing, like what all things are getting covered now. Yeah, right. So that makes sense. So that is why I wanted to concentrate on the very first day, who are all the people, from what level I should be starting, and I just immediately don't want to go in the SAP system. I just wanted to people understand, make up a mind what all things are covered, what all we'll be discussing in future sessions, and how SAP system can help in addressing those business problems which are nowadays becoming very significant. So companies are looking more into these things, and for profit is important, but sustainability has become even more important. With last few years there have been cases where companies are now realizing that they cannot be profitable if they're not sustainable. So that is where SAP solutions come into picture, and that is why there is a increasing demand for consultants in these areas. And that is why I want to first concentrate on these slides first today, at least. Then we'll go into the system. So going ahead, these are some of the concepts which will be used in the system. So just to make up your mind, we call something as work area. So most of the stuff around health and safety and industrial hygiene will be, the work area will be the center point of most of the solutions. So work area can be anything. It can be a function locations where equipments are installed. It can be a person also. It can be a work center, a storage location for material or the material in itself, or the place where probably buildings and all those things where the production is not happening, but still it can be a work area. And around that only we'll be doing many SAP business processes, and we'll be getting some end results around that. So this is how the work area will play an important role when we go into the system and try to see how which incident has happened in which area, what is the risk rating of which area, what is the standard operating procedure for which equipment, which area has which inspection results, and likewise so many other things. So we'll see later. So risk management we already talked about. So when I'm saying risk management, it's not only limited to typical EHS risk. Nowadays EHS risks are more broader, which covers your logistic risks, your maintenance risks, your auditing risks also. So we'll try to see some of those things in system. But when I say risk management, it's an integrated approach which SAP nowadays taking based on newer risk methodologies in the market, right? This is one typical process where again health and safety things are happening, and this time The process shows that based on the exposure levels of the employee who is working in a particular area or with a particular process, some job rotations can also happen. An employee can be, his health can be proactively monitored before some damage happens to the employee health. So those sort of integration is also possible in SAP based on time-weighted average of employee exposed to certain gas or certain ergonomics or certain noise or certain radiations. Those levels can be measured on a real-time basis, and employee rotations are possible even before his health has gone deteriorated. So those things we'll see in the system. And this is something called as hazardous substance register, where MSDR and standard operating procedures as well as inventory of hazardous substance are tracked. Some regulations demands that you track the level of hazardous substances in your company, and it cannot go beyond the threshold level. Those sort of things, SAP has some capabilities, so those are also possible in the system. Product safety and stewardship, this is the core solution of SAP, and this is a solution from where SAP started its journey in EHS management systems. So when they initially started building the EHS system, they started from this solution only, which consists of all these, which you can see on the slide. And this formed the base of the complete EHS system, whether it's health and safety or it's product-related compliances or to some extent environmental things also. So we'll be spending most of our training into these things only. These things, if you see the specification management, forms the base of the complete EHS solutions, where we define the specifications for many things, for end product also, for raw materials also, for vendor sourced materials also, for recipes also, for intermediates also, for pure substances, listed substances, even listed substances. So this forms the base of entire EHS system. And the phrase management is something where depending on what sort of document you are producing, you need to maintain so many textual information in the system, and that needs to comply with many guidelines of the reporting and compliances also. That we'll see how it is built in the system. And report information system are the placeholders where all the reports can be seen, whether this is MSDS or product label, material safety data sheet, or dangerous goods related reports that we'll see. And global label management talks about the labels which you can see on the product. It can be product label, it can be container label, it can be packaging label. That we'll see how it gets printed from the system, how system plays a role in ensuring that you have correct label, correct information on the label. Substance volume tracking is something which tracks the volume to the lowest level of information and maintains the compliances for the products or the company who authorized to deal in regulated substance like lead or any other regulated substance as per the law. Reach compliance, something which is European Union specific, we are not covering in this training, which is very specialized solution of sustainability. Dangerous goods management is something when you are dealing in the dangerous goods as classified by the UN regulation. So we'll be covering most of the training will be around these solutions only, which forms the base of EHS. This is a typical safety process where generation of MSDS material safety data sheet. I'm not sure, Gaurav, if you are aware of MSDS or not.
Yes, I am completely aware of MSDS. In fact, I work as an EHS manager.
Oh, great. So it feels good when people from industry are there in the training. So I can go with the flow. Not sure this recording, when Venki will be distributing to others, how comfortable they will will be with all the terms, but still for the benefit of all the audience or future audience, I am going to the level which probably you two people, at least in this call, might already be aware of. So you can think I am going to much lower levels or much levels below your knowledge, then you can think that I am probably addressing those people who might be new to those concepts, right? So yeah, so SAP also caters to these type of solutions where every new material or for the change in the material, you need to have a new version of MSDS or a new MSDS or at the same time a new version of label or the new label itself. It starts right from the creation of or updation of the left material. And this is the process which is automated in SAP to a fair extent. And the calculations or the logics which should be applied for many of the dynamic things that is taken care by SAP expert rules which you see here on the tree. And these expert tools are very specialized calculations which SAP provides as part of their regulatory content, and this helps you to have a foolproof database which can finally come as an output on your MSDS and labels. And this is integrated with your sales process, like for every customer's you need to give MSDS in an year or within a 2 year slot, or when a product changes again you need to ship MSDS. So this process ensures that for every sales order delivery you are having a MSDS copy already sent to customers, either electronically or a printed copy. The same checks can be done for labels also, and we'll see in subsequent slides some of the checks for dangerous goods also. This is something which is a typical process in SAP. You'll understand more when I come to SAP screens, but from your business experience you might be understanding what this is trying to say. So from bill of material in EHS we call that as bill of substance, and we go to the lowest level of pure substance and then do some calculations and finally generate the document. This Windows Word integration is something which is a proprietary tool of SAP to generate the documents, clients' documents in exactly Windows format, Word format, and with all the Word formatting. So we'll see those things in system. So SAP system is capable of generating multilingual reports and labels, and that is why the phrases which are maintained, that can be maintained in almost all of the language, main languages world across the world. So we'll see how those things are handled in SAP. SDS distribution, like I was talking with the sales scenario, it can be the MSDS process can be integrated, and it can be ensured that for every delivery the logic can be also built, MSDS can be automatically shipped or automatically printed depending how the customer want that, and that is an integration which is possible in SAP. Dangerous goods movement, very important and very critical. The dangerous goods checks, the sales process, the deliveries which are happening, the product deliveries which are happening out of the company, it should not happen. The correct mode of transport should be ensured that this product can only go through road. It should not be allowed via sea or via air or vice versa, and these are the things which needs to be ensured before this product is shipped and before this delivery is created. And these are the delivery under delivery note, these are dangerous goods information that needs to be printed. All those things are ensured through dangerous goods management process in EHS, and that we will see. It is again very tightly integrated with the sales process, and those integrations are very much possible in EHS systems. Yeah, these are the things I was talking for. There's so many regulations across the world which you need to adhere to depending on your mode of transport and the consignment is going from which country to which country. So route management and packing management and classification of data has to be done as per the UN guidelines, and this needs to be consistent across your product portfolio. Things we'll see is a sample screenshot how that happened, that classification and transport approvals happen, and how that plays role in the sales cycle. And this is how the routes are determined, and some of the information gets printed out of loading check. So just to give an idea what all things we will be probably covering in the training, because if I directly start in the system, you'll not understand the big picture, what we'll be covering and how, what will be your expectation out of the system. This is the same thing for the label, where finally we'll be seeing how labels are defined and how labels are printed. Label process can be integrated with your production process as well as your sales process also. So there are various business processes with which the label process is integrated. We will see all those possibilities in the system. This is how the labels look like, right? These all things are possible in SAP to produce this type of labels and to be printed along with all these pictograms. So those things we'll see. This is very specific solutions which will not be going much into detail into the system, but this is something which is nowadays becoming important in some of the countries like US and some of the European countries has very strict regulation around this substance volume tracking. Like you might have heard of SARA reporting of Toxic Substance Control Act of US. Those things are ensured here. This is a solution which is having the to handle those type of reportings and checks in your system for no further purchase order or no further sales order. For both purchase and sales scenario, it can restrict or give you a warning message if you are going to cross the threshold limit of the regulated substances where you are operating, where you are producing, or where you are purchasing or selling the products. So that we'll see later. Environment performance is a very, very broad topic. This in itself is a separate training. It's a very broad topic, and SAP as on date is not having very robust solution in some of the pockets. Like although this slide talks about so many things, still the like energy and resource management is, although it is a EHS concern, but the SAP solution portfolio is not very robust. So it has a capability, but it still is done outside EHS solution. Permit and certificate management, which in some countries like US, they are having this system of EHS where they are doing permit and certificate management out of environment compliance solution of EHS. Base management we'll cover as part of this training, because this is a solution which, irrespective of the region or countries, most of the client have already invested into this. And it is being happening. Wastewater discharge management, again, not many clients are as on date is having an EHS solution for this. Air emission management is definitely one solution which SAP has very robust solution, but that in itself is a very broad topic, which in itself is a different training altogether. So we'll be covering this on a conceptual level, except waste management, where we'll be going in detail in the system. Rest all other things we'll see on the conceptual level only. So waste management, as the name suggests, will cover entry document waste manifest, which is the document which gets generated from the system for disposing of the waste, consignment note and disposal documents, and this has integration with the SAP's other solution of material management and costing, because there will be cost involved for disposing of the waste if you are hiring some channel partners. And yeah, so these are the business partners. You'll have waste generator that can be your own company who is generating the waste. you might be taking the services of some transporter. If you are not yourself transporting, some authorized waste disposer, and finally the government authority to whom you might be submitting the reports. So those all things, so we'll see how happen in the system and how it happens with integration with your other SAP modules of materials management and costing. So these are some of the process scenarios which we'll see briefly in the system. Finally, the larger picture looks like this. This is an architecture diagram where we'll be covering mostly which is there in the box called as SAP EHSM in Environment Health and Management Safety Management System. We'll be covering mostly on this, and this is how it communicates with other part of the world. These are the external services like WWI service, which will finally give me a Word or PDF type of a document, whether it's a MSDS document or a label or waste manifest or a standard operating procedure or an incident accident report. Those all things will come from this external services called as Windows Word integration. Expert server is something, is a server, will be the server which will give the expert calculations based on certain logics or certain output which needs to come on these all documents, where you can give a dynamic logic to it. Adobe document, wherever there will be requirement of Adobe documents that this system can be used for creating. And this all happen through RFC. RFC is called as remote function call. This is some technical word in SAP. Through which two different servers or two different system communicates. On the right hand side, you see there's a box called ECC. ECC is your enterprise core component, which is where most of the older EHS, older SAP solutions reside. When I say older, that means when SAP as a company started, they started with materials, they started with sales process, they started with HR process, plant maintenance process, FI, financial costing, all those things. And this, our EHS system, keep on communicating with EHS system. This is an add-on. In SAP language, this is called as an add-on. So it sits on top of ECC system and communicates natively. It doesn't communicate through RFC. It communicates natively. It is inbuilt inside, but it still sits on top of that. And in between, we have product and reach compliance, which is again very, very specialized solutions, catering mostly to the European region and some very specialized regulations across the world. And this in itself is a training. And finally, SGM is pulling all data from all the modules. At bottom, there's an environmental box also. And finally, publishing your integrated report or sustainability report. So this will be the architecture, solution architecture, for you to understand the complete picture. And to assist customers in managing, because most of the customer will be having hundreds and thousands of chemicals and products, and if one has to break those products into smallest component of pure substances or raw materials, then you have more specifications. So SAP helps you with up-to-date regulatory information around all those things, and a customer doesn't need to break his head collecting all those information if a customer wants to set up an EHS system. Not only the information, regulatory information, but also the logic, expert calculations, and many phrases SAP provides in all the languages. And they keep on updating those things, and they keep on publishing quarterly updates so that your system is up to date and compliant with new regulations or change regulations. So this is part of SAP offering, which is licensed separately, and that needs to be purchased by customer if they don't want the headache of maintaining those data themselves. And finally, I come to the end of the presentation. And yeah, any questions before we conclude for today at least? And next session will probably start going into some part of the system. Yep. So how many people are there?
Sachin, Gaurav.
Yeah, Sachin.
If you have any doubts, you can ask your doubts. Sachin, are you able to hear?
Hey Sachin, Sachin joined late, I think. Sachin, could you see some of the slides?
Just I joined before 10 minutes. Okay. So, I just little bit part of this presentation. Okay.
Sachin, can you give your background so that we can understand what exactly is your experience into this?
Rohit, actually, I am currently working on a plant maintenance. Okay. And here I am looking incident management part of the EHS.
Okay. So you are more in, because it has more integration with the plant maintenance.
Right. That the IM number will create and all net inventory information. Okay. And all process will continue right now. So my sincere interest is in a product safety data management and all the global level management.
Okay.
In perspective of that, I am looking this course and all.
Okay. Good to know that you already know SAP solution and you are doing consulting in SAP PM area, is that right?
Yeah, in PM.
Okay.
And currently I am working on oil and gas project.
Okay, then you will have more interest into industrial hygiene and safety and not more into product safety side, but more on incident management and environment management. Yeah.
Different.
Okay. You ask your question. I am done for the day. I was just asking Vinky because we had scheduled for 1 hour. So I am from my side. I am done. You people have questions. Otherwise, we'll go to the next session, and you can access the this recorded session also probably, and we can directly in the next session go to the system.
I will send you that recorded session. So you can also check it, and you can, if you have any more doubts, you can mail me. Gaurav and Tushar, they have any questions? They are available for chatting.
No, currently I don't have any question. Session is very much fine, and it's good to have nice introduction about the what are the aspects covered in the EHS and how it will be integrated in SAP.
So what about
I think I don't have any question. But I would really like to know more about product safety and stewardship because that is the one that I'm interested in.
Anyway, yeah, Gaurav, so most of our training will be around that area only, like I was saying. So we'll be going much more into product safety things as well as incident management thing. So these are the things which we'll cover much more into detail in our subsequent sessions.
Okay. One more thing that I wanted to ask is, you spoke mostly about industrial hygiene, waste management, occupational health and safety. See, all these are like, you said it is an add-on to ECC, right?
Yeah.
So ECC is nothing but the ERP, ERP solution that is basic ECP solution with PM, MM modules.
Yeah. So let me tell you background. Sachin is already here, so he might be already aware. When SAP started building these ERP solutions way back in 70s, 80s, so obviously they will first start with some modules like which are very much in any organization, like finance, costing, materials, then sales process, then purchase process, and then probably plant maintenance and other modules. So when SAP started, they were more focused on these things. EHS, they realized importance from 90s onwards. So there was a different company that was a Technidata company, which was the contractor for SAP to build EHS solutions throughout these and 2000. And later at the end of 2000, 2010 around, they acquired that company. So That is why this was built as an add-on. This was not part of ECC, and that has been continued. Now they are more merging into the new solution is coming in the market. SAP is releasing that is called as S4HANA. Now in S4HANA, that will be part of the entire core solution, because this is the new suite of solution SAP is coming with.
So we need to have this ERP solution first in the organization, and only then we can move on to SAP EHS, right?
Yes, so you need to have ERP already implemented, then only you can install it as an add-on, activate this as an add-on.
Okay, and one more thing is that what is that R4 HANA? HANA is the version of SAP, I believe.
Oh, if you are interested in that topic, that is a big topic in itself. S4HANA, there's nothing like 4 is having any significance. Since they the previous version of SAP or previous suite of SAP was called as R3, it was 3-tier architecture. They are going now saying it as S4HANA. Earlier it was 4, like we say that Rohit for training. So FOR you can also write in short 4. So okay. SAP for HANA. So there's no significance of 4 here as such from an architecture point of view. If I'm not wrong, as far as I know, there's no significance of 4 in the term as 4 HANA.
But we don't need to know HANA.
No, we don't need to know. I just explained you because you were asking add-on. So I shared the complete story with you. Now, yeah. S4HANA onwards, it will be part of the core.
I think, I'm done with
it. Yeah.
So, any more questions? I will end up the session.
One more, sorry. So, really sorry. Can we get the PPT?
Yeah, I can share the PPT.
Yeah, we will.
Venky and
I will, once of the started classes, I will give you that PPT and everything. Okay. Tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
I will update you tomorrow the class timings and everything. And a few more is there, but today not joined. I think still they are in traffic. Beautiful. One is facing some that operating system issue. She's using the Apple package. So I'll send them the current. Tomorrow I will update the class times and everything. Okay? So still, if you have any more doubts, you can mail me. I will ask the trainer and I will update you. Okay?
Sure.
Right. Okay. Thanks for attending demo class. So I will meet you next class. Okay?
Okay, bye.
Okay, bye guys.
Thank you.